Hey love, welcome to Midday Motivation. I am Hope Knows and I am here to get you motivated. Now most people would agree that 2020 has sucked. I decided to take what I have learned from 2020. So today I want to give you the top 5 things that I have learned during quarantine. Now on the last Midday Motivation, I gave you the first two. The first one being that you should be your number one investment. The second one being the importance of having dedicated prayer time with God, where there's no distractions, nothing going on, so that you can truly hear what He has to tell you. And today I'm going to give you the last 3 of the top 5 things that I learned during quarantine. So let's jump right in and get to number 3. Number 3 is watch your circle. Show me your friends, I'll show you your future. We've all heard it before. And I even touched on this a little bit in number 2, the importance of not having naysayers around you and people that are going to speak negativity over you. Because when you are struggling, when you're being stretched by God to do things that are uncomfortable or out of things that you may not feel that you're qualified to do, you don't need people telling you you can't do it. So it's important that you watch your circle. You need to be associating with people that are first and foremost Christ-centered, Holy Spirit-led. Like, you need to be equally yoked spiritually, but then that also has something going for themselves. Like, if you want to be an entrepreneur or business owner, don't be trying to hang out with somebody that's content with sitting at home and not working. Like, that's just not it. Like, successful people hang out with successful people. So you need to have the right people around you. And you need to make sure that they're putting the right energy into you. So you have to have let your spirit of discernment speak to you and let the Holy Spirit lead and guide you, so you can decide if someone needs to be in your circle, if you need to limit it, if they shouldn't be in your circle at all. But you definitely need to watch your circle. So number four is people pleasing. And I touched on this a little bit in the first one when I talked about being a perfectionist. And I realized in me being a perfectionist, that was also a form of me people pleasing. Well, the reason people pleasing is so dangerous is 2 reasons. First off, we should be seeking to please God. That should be our primary focus. And then the second reason is, when you're concerned with people pleasing, a lot of times you will fall victim to comparison. So we should be seeking to please God. Let's go and start there. That should be our first priority. And if you are constantly seeking the validation of man and caring about what other people think of you, you may not be doing what God is telling you to do. Like, we've already discussed that when God makes you a promise, other people may not have heard that promise. Like, they don't know what path God has you on, what He's told you to do. So if you're focused on pleasing them and they don't even know where you're really supposed to be operating at, that could be very dangerous. Because sometimes God will ask us to do stuff that doesn't necessarily make sense, or it may not have been the path that we would have chosen. But remember, He works from the end backwards. So He knows what we need to do and when we need to do it. And so it may be something that looks kind of out of the box, or you really want me to go that way, Lord? And then so you have people over here saying, nah, that's not what you should do. But God is telling you that is what you should do. And if you are more concerned about pleasing people than you are God, then you can fall prey to operating outside of the will of God for your life. And you definitely don't want to do that. So the other thing that makes people pleasing so dangerous is comparison. And I think it's human nature to a certain extent. Like, I think our flesh just wants to compare. Like, it's something I struggle with. I look at other people like, man, like, they doing this and I'm doing this, and then they got these results and I got comparison. I have other people come up to me, I wish I could do, you know, my videos like yours. I wish I got comparison. It's not good, because their journey and their path is theirs. My journey and my path is mine. God has specific purpose and plan for each one of us. So there's a plan and purpose for Mike's life. There's a plan and purpose for Sally's life. There's a plan and purpose for my life. But if I'm looking at Mike and trying to mimic him and walk out the plan that he's walking, then I'm out of order, because his purpose and plan is not mine. And if Mike is looking at Sally and he's trying to do the things that she's doing, then he's out of order, because his plan and purpose is not her plan and purpose is not his. So we have to be focused on ourselves. We have to remember that our only competition in this life is us. And when you can truly realize that, when you can become grounded in that, it also makes it so much easier for you to be able to celebrate others when they get success. Because now you're not gonna fall victim to hate and like, well, why they get that and I didn't get that? Because you know their victory is their victory, your victory is your victory, their plan and stuff is their plan, yours is yours, and you'll get yours in your proper time, they'll get theirs in their proper time. So you don't have to hate on anybody, you don't have to feel jealous, you're envious, anything like that. When you're able to truly grasp, God has a plan specifically for me. He has purpose specifically for me. And what is going on around me does not take that away. It does not detour that. It does not have anything to do with that. So I can uplift and be happy for other people in their successes. I can motivate them when they fall and know that what God has for me is for me. So I want to encourage you to make sure that you are not comparing yourself. So those are the two issues that you can run into when you're people pleasing. Now the final one, number five of the five things that I learned through quarantine is prioritize what matters. Yeah, you gotta prioritize what matters. And I think sometimes when we look at prioritizing what matters, we feel like that's where all of our time and focus and attention should go. And of course, there's probably places you'd rather spend 40 hours of your life each week than at your job, but you need that good old paycheck. But it doesn't mean you can't prioritize those things that are more important. You may not be able to put the same amount of time into it, but you can definitely make sure that the time that you put is quality, even if you can't get that quantity. Now, I've always had the mentality of work hard, grind. I say I'm a goal-getter, like I'm just in there. But what I learned in quarantine is like, yeah, hard work is good, but you have to prioritize what is important. And the reality is, accolades, business, work, all of that, that's not the things that are most important in life. Like, I have seen a lot of people die. When I say seeing them die, I mean literally on their deathbed. And when people are on their deathbed, they're not asking for their bank accounts. They're not asking for their credit cards or accolades that they got professionally. They don't want trophies. They don't want jewelry. They want people around them, their family, their friends, their loved ones. That is what matters, because we work so hard for these things in life that we cannot take with us. And in our last moments, our last days, they're not the things that matter. So I had to learn how to prioritize what mattered to me. Now, for me, my list may not be the same as yours, but for me, it's God first, of course. So I am going to be intentional, making sure I give God his time first. And then right after that is me. It's self. And a lot of times we'll put spouses, we'll put children, we'll put other things above ourselves. But I'm here to tell you, taking care of you is so important. And it's more important than taking care of other people. That's why when you fly on an airplane, they make the announcement, if you have small children and the air mask deploy, then you need to put yours on first and then your children's. And the reason why they do that is because if you're too busy trying to get the oxygen mask on your kids and then you pass out, what good are you to them? So we have to take care of ourselves first in order to effectively then be able to care for others. And that's something that we as women really struggle with. We put our superwoman cape on and we run out to save the world, but we got to take care of us first, sis. Now, we talked about in the first one about being our number one investment and realizing that getting your hair and your nails done and your makeup is not all that self-care entails. So that goes back to working out, eating healthy, taking care of your body, all the things, reading a book. If you enjoy reading a book, taking 30 minutes to watch TV, if that helps you relax and decompress at the end of the day. So priority number two, when I'm prioritizing what matters, is me. Then after that comes family and friends and being there for them. Then after that comes my career, like what I am passionate about, my career and my passions, and those go hand in hand. So if you're ever trying to figure out what your purpose is, what you should be doing for a career, think about if money did not matter. Like if you were a millionaire, billionaire, I receive it, Lord, and money did not matter at all, what would you do with your life? And whatever you come up with, whatever you're passionate about, that is what you need to start looking at in terms of a career. That's what a career is, something that you would do for free if you were financially able to. So my career comes before my job. And so with career, I include passion, because my career, public speaking, being creative, writing plays, all of that is my passion. Creating artwork, things like that, that's all my passion. And so that goes in line with my career. And so then the final thing on that list is my job. Now, in reality, my job gets more time than any of those things, because it gets 40 hours a week, because I need that paycheck. Hallelujah. Thank God for it. But I don't have to prioritize my job, because I already know I'm expected to be there a certain amount of hours at a certain time, and I have things to do. But it's easy to get so caught up in doing that that you forget about the other things. So those first four things that are so important to me, I prioritize. I carve out time in my day. I put it on my calendar. I'm intentional about those things. So that is what prioritizing what matters means. So just to recap again, the five things that I learned during quarantine is, number one, you should be your number one investment. Number two, have dedicated prayer, conversation time with God. Number three, watch your circle. Number four, don't be a people pleaser. And number five, prioritize what matters. It is so important that you do that. So I came up with my five things that I learned during quarantine. And of course I learned more, but I just hit you with five. Now I want to challenge you to come up with five things that you've learned. Let's not focus on the negative. We know bad things have happened. We know this year didn't work out the way we wanted. But what can you say you've learned over the last 10 months? How can you grow and glean from it? And then once you look at what you've learned over the last 10 months, decide how you're gonna end these last 2 months of the year and then go into 2020 and beyond. Like, don't let setbacks keep you down and keep you from moving forward. Like, I'm moving forward with positivity, with outlook, with optimism, knowing that God is about to elevate me. Financial increase is coming my way. My business is growing. My health is done. Like, I'm healed. Like, I'm believing God for big things, and I want you to believe God for big things. And not only am I believing Him for those things, but I'm putting plans in place to make them happen. It would be easy for me to fold my arms and be like, 2020 sucked, and this didn't happen, and I had these speaking engagements lined up, and they got shut down. No! Okay, it happened. So let's readjust, let's shift, let's get back in there. Let's walk in our purpose, with purpose, on purpose, and be intentional about having a life that we're supposed to have, and walking in this kingdom life that God wants us to walk in, and this greatness that He wants us to walk in. Let's do this. You got it. I believe in you. I'm challenging you. You can do it. Yes. I love you so much. I am Hope Knows. This has been your Midday Motivation, and I will see you the next time. Bye.